Why the first king of Srivijaya Empire have Dapunta Hyang title? You can find out in this video. And keep tuning to this video to Kingdom Theory video. The title of Dapunta Hyang for kings of Srivijaya Empire. The title of Dapunta Hyang, both in the Talang Tua inscription and in the Kedukan Bukit inscription, we could find on both the title of Dapunta Hyang, without knowing exactly for whom the title was intended. Considering that according to Chinese ancient books or ancient news from the history of Song Dynasty, many families in the Sanfosi Kingdom or Srivijaya Kingdom had Pu titles. So the title Dapunta Hyang must be reserved for people who has very high status in society. Very high honor was shown by the addition of Da, Ta, and Hyang, not just Pu. The use of title is different according to time and place. Therefore, maybe the same designation or title has different meaning in Java and Sumatra. Today, for example, the word Teku or Tengku in Aceh and the Malay Peninsula shows the man which has it is the close descendants of the king or noble family. Likewise, the title or designation of Tengku and Ungku in Johor, for example. However, the term Tengku in Minangkabau is used to refer to a teacher. The degree is the same as the current usage in Indonesia and Cikgu in Singapore. For example, Engku Sulaiman in Minangkabau is the same with Cikgu Sulaiman in Singapore and Pak Sulaiman in Indonesian noun. In short, the title or designation in its use can undergo semantic changes. In the charter from 860 AD in Java, there was the title Dapunta, namely Dapunta Aganda. Another example is Dapunta Panunggalan, Dapunta Marbyang. Dapunta Anggada is a monastery official. However, Dapunta is a title associated with life in a monastery in Java. Until now, according to the Kasparis, there has been no evidence to suggest that Dapunta was used as the title of the king in Java. If we look at the other inscription as an analogy, then based on that analogy, it can be concluded. What I mean is a title found in the Khmer Charter, which has been published by Codes in 1918. And in the Kartanegara Charter found on the banks of the Langsat River. The name of the Malay King or Srivijaya King in the Khmer inscription or Khmer Charter is Srimat Trailokya Raja Mauli Busana Warmadewa, and in the Kartanegara inscription Srimat Tribuana Raja Mauli Warmadewa. Both use the title Srimat, which in South India meaning Lord, and are used specially in religious life. But the title Srimat in the Malayu Kingdom territory in 1286 AD was clearly used as the title of king. The word Srimad as a title in South India is exactly the same as the word Dapunta in Java in 860. Both are used as monastic title. If we know Srimad Trailokya Raja Mauli Busana Warma Dewa in the Khmer inscription and Srimad Tribhuwana Raja Mauli Warma Dewa in the Kartanegara inscription, then in the Talang Tuoch inscription, we know Dapunta Hyang Sri Jayanasa. Dapunta Hyang gave a message to all the people to enjoy the garden prize. Until now, people have opinion that the Talang Tuo Charter is the Srivijaya Charter, and the park was given by the Srivijaya King. Presumably, the one who gave the message was the King of Srivijaya. The one who gave the message was the person with the title Dapunta Hyang. All grandiose praises and prayer are for Dapunta Hyang, who gives garden gifts. So logically, Dapunta Hyang is the title of the King of Srivijaya. In the Talang Tuo inscription, the one with the title Dapunta Hyang is Sri Jayanasa. So Sri Jayanasa was the King of Srivijaya in 684 AD. In Kedukan Bukit inscription, it is also called Dapunta Hyang without a name. Same with Dapunta Hyang in Talang Tuo inscription, line 2. Considering that the time difference between the Kedukan Bukit Charter and the Talang Tuo Charter is only 1 year, then presumably the Dapunta Hyang on Kedukan Bukit is also Dapunta Hyang, Sri Jayanasa too. If the Dapunta Hyang in the Kedukan Bukit inscriptions is only the title of abode, like Dapunta Aganda, then it is quite strange that the abbot interfere with military affair. Also, in the Talang Tuo inscription, it is quite strange that the abbot gives a garden gift, not just one but many, to the community. Usually, the abbot gets a gift from the king or other dignitaries. That raises the suspicion that Dapunta Hyang is the abbot, except for comparison with Dapunta in the old Javanese inscription, as well as the discovery of inscription fragments, where there are fragments of sentences that read, "This monastery in this Diwanua." It is clear that Dapunta Hyang came to Mata Danau to make Wanua. From the fragments of the inscription, it is evident that in Wanua there is a monastery. Based on the mindset above, the monastery was a gift of the Srivijaya King, who was entitled Dapunta Hyang. From the various inscriptions, it is evident that the kings of Srivijaya were very kind toward Buddhism, even becoming a proponent for the religion. At very least, the Srivijaya king would be the protector if he did not actively interfere in religious matter. Also in the Nalanda inscription, it is stated that Balaputra, a god who calls himself Swarna Dwipa Di Pamaharaja, a descendant of Yama Bhumipala, established a monastery in Nalanda. Although according to the interpretation of the matter of establishing the monastery, it had a political purpose, namely to strengthen friendship and then to get help from India. But in terms of religion, the gift of the monastery showed the Srivijaya king's inclination toward Buddhism. About this Balaputra Dewa will be elaborated more in the back. In the Leiden In the laden inscription written in Tamil, it was also stated that Sri Marawijaya Tunggawarman, the son of King Sudamaniwarman, descended from Sailendra dynasty, King Kataha and Srivijaya, presented a village in Nagipatana. His father gave a monastery named Chudamaniwarman Vihara. The prize was given in the first years of the reign of King Kola Raja Raja I, from 1005 to 1006 AD. In his friendship with China, the king of Sanfosi, Tihua Kalo or Kalotunga, repaired the Tinching Temple in Canton and presented 400,000 gold coins, which were then used to buy rice fields to foster the temple and the people priests at the monastery. King Sanfosi Tihua Kalo Man get the nickname of great general who support the renewal of worship and virtue. The repair of the Tinching Temple was carried out in 1079 AD. From the example above, it is evident that the Srivijaya king often gives monasteries for the benefit of religious life abroad. It is not strange if the king of Srivijaya also presented a monastery in his own country, which was commemorated by the inscription fragment found in Telaga Batu, where Dapunta Hyang founded monastery. The awarding of the monastery was related to the glorious journey carried out by Dapunta Hyang from Waratebo over the victory over the Melayu Kingdom, with 20,000 troops in the procession. The construction of such monastery is a normal phenomenon, a manifestation of gratitude. The construction of the Tara Temple in Kalasan in 778 also coincided with the emergence of the Panangkaran Pancapana Sailendra and the cessation of the Sanjaya Rupa, which used the Sanjaya Date calculation. The last charter that used the Sanjaya Date is the Mountain Spurs Charter. The construction of the sacred building as a manifestation of the gratitude of a king is so much done abroad. I think that's all for the title of Dapunta Hyang. In a nutshell, we conclude that Dapunta Hyang is the title for a king. Unlike in Java, the Dapunta is the title for a monastery leader, but in this case in Srivijaya in Sumatra, Dapunta is used for the title of the king, which is King Dapunta Hyang Sri Jayanasa, which is the first king of Srivijaya Empire. I think that's all for me at this point. Thank you for your kind attention. See you on my next YouTube video. Please don't like to like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.